We began in ignorance, fighting a war that we did not understand against weapons we never dreamt existed. We were unready. We were vulnerable. We were weak. But in those first moments, our enemies gave us strength. The strength to live, to rise from the bloody fields, to march on, but not to fall. All this is ours now, and was not before.
There are many Astartes amongst the loyalist legions who fight and die in the name of the Emperor. Great martyrs are born in moments of sacrifice. Their legendary defiance against chaos and the fell Xenos of the galaxy, a cornerstone of the Imperium's might. Though there is only one Astartes chapter that honors the finest blade of their battle brothers as Emperor's Champion. And that title originates from a singular warrior of Rogal Dorn's 7th Legion, first captain of the Imperial Fists, Sigismund. A Terran-born Astartes, Sigismund rose through the ranks of the Imperial Fists due to his relentless lethality and prowess in combat. It is often argued which hero of the Imperium's illustrious history is the greatest amongst their peers, but none of these arguments bear merit without the inclusion of Sigismund. Undefeated in combat, Sigismund gained a reputation during the Great Crusade amongst all Astartes legions as a noble yet ferocious warrior. Fighting alongside his Primarch, Sigismund, though brash and headstrong, would serve as Rogal Dorn's greatest warrior, seen less as an Astartes and more as a symbol of the Praetorian of Terror's invincible will. Sanguinius, Primarch of the Blood Angels, would even remark about Sigismund, saying that he was less the champion of Dorn, and more fittingly, the champion of death itself. During the Great Crusade, the Imperial Fists and World Eaters would wage war together on numerous occasions. As the foremost champions of their legions, Sigismund and Khan, equerry to the Primarch Angron, would become close comrades. Referring to one another as Oath Brothers, Sigismund would gain a reputation in the World Eater fighting pits on their flagship Conqueror, earning the moniker of Black Knight. Sigismund's time spent with the World Eaters would lead to him adopting the 12th Legion's custom of chaining their weapons to one arm, leading to the Black Templar practice known as devotional chains. During the beginning of the Horus Heresy, Sigismund would be one of the first loyalist Astartes to confront Captain Nathaniel Garrow of the Death Guard Legion on board the battle-scarred ship known as the Eisenstein. Upon Garrow relaying the warning of Horus's betrayal to Rogal Dorn, the Vigilant would isolate himself from his legion. Once Dorn had decided on a plan of action, he would command Sigismund to evaluate the credibility of Horus's betrayal. During his moments of inner turmoil, Sigismund would speak with Euphrates Keeler, the former Imagus serving alongside the Lunar Wolves Legion of Astartes, and first living saint of the Imperium. She would warn Sigismund that soon the traitor legions would invade Holy Terror, and that he would be forced to choose where he would stand in the coming battle. Showing him a vision of the possible future, Keeler would reveal the death of the Imperium itself, his corpse another unremembered son, added to the pile. The other choice resulting in his death, but with the elucidation of his virtue, the survival of the Imperium, and his duty to his Primarch fulfilled. Sigismund would request Dorn to allow him to remain at his side, which his Primarch allowed, but with uncertainty as to his finest warrior's reasoning. In Sigismund's place, Captain Yonad would serve his Primarch. Though Rogal Dorn trusted Sigismund's plea without reservation or objection. The Imperial Fists would be recalled to Holy Terror with the news of the coming betrayal and be tasked with fortifying the throne world. Masters of fortification and siegecraft, the Emperor's Praetorians would prepare for the coming onslaught. However, Dorn would send forth 30,000 Astartes of his legion to combat the forces of Chaos stationed in the Istvan system. With over 500 ships, they would be dubbed the Retribution Fleet. Whilst overseeing the fortification constructions on Terra, word would reach Rogal Dorn of the massacre of Istvan V. The death of Iron Hand Primarch Ferus Manus and the destruction of his legion, the betrayal of the Night Lords, Iron Warriors, Alpha Legion, and Word Bearers, and the near annihilation of the Loyalist Raven Guard and Salamander Legions, the Primarchs of both legions missing in action. And with all this, his Retribution Fleet had not returned. Enraged, Dorn would command Sigismund to purge the Sol system of any betrayers to the throne, given whatever means Sigismund saw fit to achieve his Primarch's goals. Before his dispatch, Sigismund would reveal the vision he had seen to his Primarch, and the reasoning for his request to stay at his side. Dorn would rebuke his gene son, reminding him that Astartes nor Primarch chose their duty to the Emperor. Their fate was not to choose, only to serve. With his Primarch's trust squandered, and ashamed at his deception, Sigismund offered his Primarch his blade, the Black Sword, requesting he end his life rather than live in shame. Dorn would refuse to kill his loyal son, but would no longer allow him to sow doubt or fear or superstition within his legion's ranks. Those would be Sigismund's burden alone. Dorn would disown his son, but Sigismund, ever the dutiful captain, would resolve not to stew in his pity nor abandon the cause he had been shown by Euphrates Keeler. He would be there to protect his gene father. He vowed to himself that he would not fail. Horus Lupercal's invasion of Terra would birth legends and heroes aplenty, and during the Siege of Terra, Rogal Dorn would bestow Sigismund the title of Emperor's Champion. Serving as the Almighty's personal champion, though humbled, Sigismund's armor would be painted in the white and black of the champion's colors. He felt disturbed that his heraldry of the Imperial Fists would be replaced, but was set at ease by the 7th Legion High Chaplain, stating that the reclusiasm served in the Emperor's name, and Sigismund was kindred in this honor. Sigismund would scour the battlefield, challenging the champions of chaos to single combat and slaughtering anything that stood in his path. The Imperial Fists would remain stationed on Terra for the remainder of the siege, with their Primarch Rogal Dorn, Primarch Sanguinius, and the Emperor, beloved by all, assaulting the flagship of Horus Lupercal, the Vengeful Spirit. With the traitor legions repelled from Terra, Primarch Rabute Gilliman would create a tome, the Codex Astartes, to regulate the legions to prevent any further betrayals by limiting their amassed strength. Sigismund would be chosen to lead the Imperial Fist's second founding chapter, the Black Templars, as its first High Marshal. The Black Templars would embrace the chapter markers of the black and white panoply of war, first donned by Sigismund during the Siege of Terra. Their High Marshal resolving that a gesture of supreme faith in the Emperor was required for his Imperium to survive. Restless and with Ironforge zealous rage, the Black Templars would initiate the longest unbroken crusade in humanity's history. For 10,000 years, the Templars would lay waste to the enemies of the Imperium, and every subsequent High Marshal that followed in Sigismund's place would swear an oath for this holy crusade's renewal and continuation. Sigismund's last battle would be pitted against the inheritor of the arch-traitor's heretical ideals, Abaddon the Despoiler. During 781 of the 31st millennium, Abaddon would be discovered leading a host of traitor and demon forces, enacting the first in a number of his accursed Black Crusades. Warmaster Abaddon had schemed within the Eye of Terror for centuries, building his newly assembled Black Legion of traitor Astartes. The Black Templars would stand against the traitor forces, Sigismund at their lead. With over 1,000 years of service to his Imperium, though blunted by age, was nonetheless still deadly enough to instill fear in all enemies of his Imperium. Sigismund's quest to find Abaddon complete, he would inform the Despoiler that during his onslaught at the Siege of Terra, when the flames of heresy still burned upon its scarred visage, lesser men had impeded his path, their lives forfeit in preventing his blade from cutting down Horus's most favored son. The two ancient warriors would fight, the ebony black sword and the talon of Horus clashing until Sigismund plunged his sword through the Warmaster's chest. Despite such a crippling blow, Abaddon would disembowel Sigismund with his talon, another legendary foe's blood lavering the claw's vicious blades.
"Sigismund,"
Abaddon said, through lips darkened by his own lifeblood.
"This claw has killed 2 Primarchs. It wounded the Emperor unto death. I would have spared it the taste of your life as well, if only you could see what I have seen.
As I stared through Abaddon's eyes, I confess I expected the triteness of some night oaf, or a final murmur in the Emperor's name. Instead, the ruined thing that had been first captain of the Imperial Fists and High Marshal of the Black Templars spoke through a mouthful of blood, committing the last of his life to biting off each word, ensuring he spoke each one in shivering, sanguine clarity.
You will die as your weakling father died, soulless, honorless, weeping, ashamed.
Sigismund's last word was also his last breath. It sighed out of his mouth, taking his soul with it. This has been a tale of the great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. The sons of Baal have spoken. The next hero of the Imperium, to be elucidated, has been chosen.